Hello everyone and welcome back. Welcome to my brand new playlist on React Formic. So React Formic is a library which I'm going to cover in this playlist, and we are going to talk about how to write forms in React. Okay, so first of all, why I choose to create this playlist and try to talk about this, I mean why this Formic library is important for writing React components. So there are many aspects. If you just look at the React, you might have created already the basic HTML forms in React.js code, and you might have faced, okay, we need to handle the submit events. If you are writing a very basic HTML form with two or three form fields, then it is fine. But what about when you are writing a complex forms? React is not providing any native library to handle the forms. Like in Angular, we have a reactive forms, template-driven forms. In Vue.js also, we might have something. But in React also, because React is not a framework. React is a library. If you want to do any out-of-the-box functionality, then you might be using some any library like Redux, React Redux, React Formic, React Material. All these things are external. So you have to plug that in with the React components. Okay. So why React Formic is, first of all, popular? If you just talk about the forms library in React, then React Formic is far ahead than any other library, because it is giving a lot of advantage on top of other libraries which we have. Okay, so writing the basic simple forms in React is very easy. We don't have any issue. We just write on change event, on submit event, and we are able to capture the values from text fields. Like you write a simple registration form, you can do the validation and all these things. But when the number of components, number of form fields increased, when you want to do a custom validation, you wanted to do custom error messages, you wanted to check, okay, user has checked this particular field or not, user has entered or user has touched this particular form field or not, should I show the error message if user have not even touched that particular field, right? So all those things, managing that with React is always a complex. I mean, you will be managing that through the state, and you will keep rendering that form component unnecessarily. Okay, so the solution is for this is we have to use Formic, and Formic is using the renderer props mechanism for writing the forms. That is a separate thing. We will talk about it. Let's first talk about what is the advantage of using Formic library. Okay, the end goal for us is to capture the value from the forms and maybe submitting this to some APIs, right? This is what any general form do. Either you write React Native, React, Angular, Vue.js, you have some form fields, you enter the data and submit that, right? Most of the web applications have some kind of a data entry mechanism where you do a login, register, reset password, forget password. Almost every place you are end up having some kind of a form wherever the user data entry is required. And validating the form, writing the form, handling the correct way of validation is always required. Otherwise, it can give a bad user experience if your basic input fields are not working for the end user while he is entering the values. Okay. So React Formic is a library which is providing a proper way of handling the errors in a forms. It is providing all these events like on change event, on submit events. It is handling the form submission progression, form validations of all different type of fields. You can write your own custom validations. So there are a huge number of advantages if you are using Formic library. This is equal importance in React as we write Redux, right? Redux is also external library, and we use React Redux. Redux is popular. But since a long time, I'm using Formic, and I find out that Formic library is an equal candidate to be a popular same as Redux. Okay, this is my understanding, because I see that when you are writing a forms with Formic, everything gets easier. Your error handling, form submission, showing the error message, capturing the values from the forms, all gets simpler. And we always want something like this, so that without any problems, without any issues, we should be able to write forms in React. Okay. So from the tagline of this library itself is write forms without tears. Means It is simplifying the process, okay? So this is the basic simple form we have. Let me just see this, okay? And this is our basic form component. In typical React, what we do is we write custom hooks to capture the values, or we can just have some kind of a local state, like this is the form data, and on the onChange event. So this is a simple form without formic. Here I have an input and onChange event. I am triggering this value handle change, and what handle change is doing, if we just see this, it is just setting up the values coming from the form. Now this form field can be a username, password, every form field we will be able to handle, because we are setting it from the name value pair, right? So now either you can have, so this is onChange value name. Here you can have another field, which is password. You just change the name, password field, form data dot password. So with this, this is a simple form without formic. You can keep increasing these fields. What you just need to take care is you need to keep this name as a unique. Input type text, again input type email, you can say name is email, and here you have email, enter email. Simple form, and every method is handling the same method, handle change. And what handle change method is doing, it is updating the state and setting the correct key value pair. If you are entering the value in the name, it will be updating the name and value. If you are updating the email, then it will be updating email and its value. Okay, we can also see this when you are actually submitting this value, set state, we should be somewhere logging it. We can actually log this, console.log, and we can log this dot state dot form data. Okay, and we can have few more attributes here. We have password, that's optional if you wanted to initialize it. Email. So this is a basic form we have created. Now we can just save it so that it can reflect. Okay, I'm using sandbox, so let's see if it works. And I open the console. Right here I got this object, and what this object is doing, this object is giving me all the values which I need, right? In this object we got a name, password and email, right? Now if you just try to see this, how it is working, let me just hide it. So what we did is we created a handle change event on all the input text fields, and on the handle change we are just setting the getting the key value pair. Key is the e.target.name and value is this. So this is the typical way of what we are doing in the React forms, basic React forms. Either you can create some kind of a hooks for this. Here we are using class-based component, so the state is initialized something like this. You can initialize state in the constructor. Here we are handling the DOM event, updating the state, updating the form data with the correct key value pair. Okay. This is what we write in simple forms. But what if my form becomes dynamic? I have a lot of things. And here also, I'm not dealing with a lot of other things, which is about form validation, providing the proper message if you haven't entered a value. And input type field can be of any type, date picker, email, proper validations need to be placed, right? So those, all those things we need to take care. And for those, we will be using React Formic library. We have like lot many other libraries are also available which are doing the same thing. Why we need these libraries? Because React is pure HTML JavaScript. It is not providing its own library to manage the form. So we can use a formic, Redux forms, and there is React Hooks forms is also a new library which is actually using hooks to provide all these kind of form validations and all. But formic is something way beyond. It is providing validations. It is using some custom schema validation for your form object. All those things are there, and it is popular than any other library. Okay, why Formic? It is declarative, intuitive, and adaptable. These are actually few features it is providing. Okay, this can be integrated with the Redux, MBox. It is the Formic is providing all different kind of implementation with the hooks, with the components, or if as a higher order component, all different implementations of Formic is available. If you wanted to use Formic component as a higher order, it's available. If you wanted to use Formic as a hook in your functional component, that is also available. And it's available with React Native also. It works with React Native, simple. So it is giving it some edge over all the other libraries. Okay, how to install it? It's an npm module, npm install minus minus save Formic. Okay, now what we will do is throughout these coming video series, we will talk about the basic examples, how to get started with the Formic, how to write the basic forms with the Formic. Earlier we were writing something else. Now, if you wanted to use Formic, then what change we have to do in our code? So same code here we are writing with the Formic. Okay, I think this was the code we have written. We had only one text fields in our code. Now what we did is we wrapped the whole code inside a Formic. If I just minimize this. Okay, so this is my component. I'm just trying to minimize this. Okay, so this is my component and I wrapped it around the Formic, and this is my simple HTML form. Okay, what I'm using renderer props. Okay, this is what the Formic is based on. Renderer props is a concept of React. Okay, in this Formic I'm initializing few things here. What is my initial state of the form, and when on submit I'm going to capture these things. So values will give me all the values which we have captured from the form. Okay, and here you can make an API call because now you got all the values from the form. Okay, and here it is an HTML form, we have the same thing, but here we got the props from the Formic. We are writing props.handleSubmit, props.handleChange, handleBlur, and we are getting the value of this input text field from the props only, props.values.name. So these values is important candidate. It is capturing all the values which you have added in the form. So you can keep adding it. So yeah, I have a name. I want to initialize one more thing like password. Okay, so you can just append one more field here. Props.handleBlur, here you can just say, okay, I have a password also. Input type text. Here also you have to take care of few things, which is name attribute. Because internally it is also calculating based on the name and ID attributes. So keep the name as same as what you are capturing. So like name is text, type is text, type can be anything, password, email, range, color. So here password, and the field name is name. Enter password. This is just a placeholder. So now you can keep adding n number of fields. It will take care of all the values. So these values will capture all the properties like username, password, email, first name, last name. You keep adding that here. What you need to take care is handle change and handle submit. These are the two methods we are getting from the props. Okay, so let's talk about this in the coming videos in detail. How to implement Formic in your basic component, how we were doing earlier without Formic, and now what has changed if we are using Formic. Okay, Formic also provide schema validations with the YUP library. Like consider that you have 20 different fields in the form, and every field has some kind of a validation mechanism. Okay, it should be email, it should be 10 characters, it should be 20 characters. So you can have a validation schema. Here you will be just passing the validate, and you will be passing the validation schema object. Okay, that validation schema object will have the object where you are specifying what validation scenarios each and every property will have. Okay, let's talk about this. This is just a starting video, and there is a long way to go. We will talk about all these things one by one. Thanks, everyone.